Hello everyone, welcome back to Studio Time with Jay Kumar. In this new series, I share some of the key optimization ideas for film scoring using my favorite digital audio workstation, Logic Pro X. In this episode, I want to talk about setting a template for scoring the first cue of your project. Create a master project. This will be empty and will have nothing but one stereo track of your finished cue. More on this later. Now from the spotting sheet, create a marker for the first cue. Note the start time code and end time code. Create a marker for cue in and cue out. Using the cycle marker, you can import the audio for only that particular cue. Now simply lock the audio region. You may also let the cue to start at bar 5. For that, simply copy the start time code and place it in the desired bar position in the project sync and press enter. I am not a fan of using the new alternative feature within the Logic Pro X, and I always prefer saving my cues as a separate project. Pictures always get edited more times, and there is nothing called a final locked edit. As there are more corporate production companies and other OTT compliances involved in recent times, don't be surprised if you are asked to reconfirm several cues right before the movie releases. Having several projects for your cues sequentially will save you from the nightmare that occurs if there is a new video edit. Here is an interesting way to name and save your projects. Ensure that they have a project title, reel number, music number, cue name, version number, your initials, film edit number, and SMPTE code. Now let's dive into what these are. Project title. It is the name of the client or the project, or it could be the actual title of the film. Example, Bollywood Diaries or BD, its acronym. Reel number, music number. It is the reel number of the film. Example, R01 M01 would imply reel number 1. Music number 1, R01 M01B would imply its second revision. Cue name. It is the name of the cue or the title. Example, Vanessa. For main titles, just keep the title of the track. Version number. It is the version number for the cue. Every time you make changes to a cue, it gets a new revised version number. Example, V1, V2, V3, and so on. Your initials. I generally keep it as JS as it implies my name. Then comes the film edit number. SMPTE denotes the time code. Even if my cue starts only at 02, 03, 24, 21, I export the cue from 02, 03, 24, so that it's easier for the showrunner or the music editor and the mixer at the dub stage to sync it to the picture. So the naming syntax goes like project title underscore reel number music number underscore cue name underscore version number underscore your initials underscore film edit number underscore SMPTE. Thanks again for watching, and do let me know if you have any specific questions in the comments.